Since the first invasive lionfish was spotted off the coast of Florida 3 decades ago, the popular pet fish have overrun coral reefs throughout the Caribbean. They have been called ravenous, destructive, and a living, breathing, devastating oil spill. Lionfish are venomous, notoriously quick breeding, and can decimate native fish populations within a few years of invading a reef. Now, a new challenge for managing the lionfish invasion has emerged. Their weight gain as they grow is different all over the Caribbean. Ecologists commonly measure biomass, or the combined weight of all the members of a local population, to study a species and make better predictions about how the population may change in the future. Researchers build models for population and biomass that include the lengths and weights of the lionfish they catch. These models help manage the invasive pest because they reflect not just how many lionfish are on a particular reef, but how large those fish are. For some animals, like dogs, there's a fairly predictable relationship between how large an animal gets and how much it will weigh. For humans, the relationship is fuzzier. Knowing that a woman is 5 feet and 8 inches tall doesn't help us determine how much she might weigh. Ecologists can use length and weight measurements to predict how large a population is overall and to estimate how old most of the individuals in the population are. Although the results wouldn't work for people, the method is much better for studying lionfish and predicting how their populations will shift. Or at least that's what coral reef managers and researchers might hope. A new study that reviews over a dozen lionfish biomass calculations across the Caribbean and Gulf of Mexico finds that even between neighboring sections of the Caribbean, lionfish do not follow the same growth patterns. Researchers caught fish that seemed to grow differently, possibly because of differences in diet. The difference isn't trivial. When researchers caught over 100 lionfish off the coast of Mexico and used biomass calculations from their other lionfish studies, they underestimated the biomass by as much as 75%, or overestimated it by as much as 140%. The margin of error was even worse for predicting individual lionfish weights, with models from other Caribbean areas estimating that lionfish might weigh 3 times more than their actual weight for a given size. This doesn't mean that the biomass models in the other studies were wrong. Rather, it suggests that there is no one-size-fits-all pattern of invasive lionfish growth, even between neighboring populations. To fight off the lionfish invasion, ecosystem managers and scientists will have to personalize their lionfish biomass calculations to their own region as much as possible. These more accurate lionfish biomass calculations will help conservationists make better decisions about where to direct funding, which islands to incentivize fishing programs on, and which ecosystems and locations may be most vulnerable. Ecologists say that lionfish are in the Caribbean to stay, and it is unlikely that other threats to Caribbean reefs, like overfishing and climate change, will budge either. Protecting Caribbean reefs and the people that depend on them requires constantly adapting strategies. And better estimations of how many hungry lionfish are lurking on a reef will, without a doubt, make those strategies work better. This post was originally made by Sierra Garcia on February 4th, 2020. It is titled, Lionfish Counting in Errors, Oh My! Challenges in Measuring Biomass of an Invasive Nuisance. This has been Ocean Bites Out Loud. Check out this post and other neat posts at oceanbites.org. Thanks for listening!